Welcome in the name of Jesus Christ, the Savior of the world. We are gathered together to worship, to proclaim Christ crucified and risen, to remember before God our sister DeLoris, to give thanks for her life, to commend her to our merciful Redeemer, and to comfort one another in our grief. All who are baptized into Christ have put on Christ. In her baptism, DeLoris was clothed with Christ, and in the day of Christ's coming, she shall be clothed with glory. Eternal God, maker of heaven and earth, who formed us from the dust of the earth, who by your breath gave us life, we glorify you. Jesus Christ, the resurrection and the life, who suffered death for all humanity, who rose from the grave to open the way to eternal life, we praise you. Holy Spirit, author and giver of life, the comforter of all who sorrow, our sure confidence and everlasting hope, we worship you. To you, O blessed Trinity, be glory and honor forever and ever. Amen. Let us sing together our opening hymn, What a Friend We Have in Jesus, that is number 742 in the red hymnal. What a Friend We Have in Jesus. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Let us pray. Almighty God, source of all mercy and giver of comfort, graciously tend to those who mourn, that casting all their sorrow on you, they may know the consolation of your love. This we pray through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. You may be seated now as we turn to words of remembrance about DeLoris. You know what? Will you use this one? That microphone's not working. I have my fancy one here, but is that okay? Thank you. Sorry.
No problem. I'd like to start out with a little family history. My mother's great-grandparents on her mother's side were Jacob Young and Marguerite Wendling, who immigrated from Alsace, France in 1881 because of the German-France War, and they settled near Locust Lane in Winnesa County. They had a son, also Jacob, who was married twice, first to Catherine Feaster and then to Mary Barth, and between them they had eight children, including my grandmother, Clara, DeLoris' mother. On my mother's father's side, her great-grandfather, Mads Solem, married a Bertha Ellefson, and they too settled in Winnesa County, and they had a son, John, who married Elizabeth Larson, and the two had 17 children. Yep, 17. Including my grandfather, Melvin, DeLoris' father. Melvin and Clara had three children, Curtis, who married Geraldine Haugen, my mom, and then Shirley, who married Donald Lisi. So after doing the math, I had two uncles and two aunts, and since my father only had one brother, I had a total of three uncles and three aunts, all who have passed on. May they rest in peace. Now, on the other hand, my mother had a totally different story. Assuming they all got married, she had 25 uncles and she had 25 aunts, one of whom is still alive and kicking at the age of 102, Melvin's youngest sister, Geneva, who lives in Des Moines. These are the wonderful genes my mother inherited to be able to live to the age of 91. Growing up on the farm, born in 1930, had to be extremely hard. I know my grandparents were very hard workers who provided for their children very well. They were not rich by any means, but I never heard my mother say they were poor. Mom, Kurt, and Shirley were those children that we all heard about. You know, the ones who had to walk to school 3 miles, uphill, both ways, in the snow, barefoot. They got through the Great Depression, polio, smallpox, and the measles. She survived World War II, the Korean conflict, the Vietnam War, and Desert Storm. She experienced the assassinations of John F. Kennedy and Martin Luther King, 9/11, and the Trump administration. Mom's favorite tragedy, though, was the O.J. Simpson saga. Mom and Dad watched every second of that Simpson murder trial, beginning to the end. Mom's mom, Clara, was a fantastic cook, and she did pass on her culinary skills onto my mom. Her homemade bread was a special treat, and just the aroma alone was enough to get the taste buds excited. My mom and Dad became much closer to each other after Dad retired. He would make all kinds of treasures out of wood, and my mom would then either paint them or she would stain them and varnish many, many keepsakes that all the children and grandchildren and great-grandchildren will be able to cherish for many years to come. In between the woodworking, my mom taught my dad how to bake. The reality was my mom was losing her eyesight due to the macular degeneration disease, and at the very end, she was almost totally blind. So Dad was her eyes, and they worked together as a team very well. and 4 years ago that team became one when Dad passed away. Mom continued on, but it was very difficult for her, and she struggled every day. So I consider this day as a blessing, because I know she is reunited with my dad and my sister, Linda. Growing up on the farm, it must have been so special to Mom. We have all heard her talk about her billy goats and milking the cows and the chickens that Uncle Kurt was so petrified of. So many great memories from 70, 80 years ago became so real for Mom just in the last week. It was just 2 nights before Mom passed, she had gotten up from her chair and she was trying to leave. Her muscles were too weak for her to walk anymore and she fell. She needed to get back to the farm. When the nurses came and found her, she was sitting by the door in her favorite position, Indian style, cross-legged. And she told the nurse she just wanted to go home. She wanted to go back to the farm. Mom, I am so happy for you today. I know you are at peace. I know you're at the farm. You're probably holding Dad's hand. You're probably pushing Linda on the swing. You're probably singing one of your favorite songs. I bet you can smell the homemade bread your mom's baking in the kitchen through that open window. And look behind you, over there in the pasture, you can see your dad plowing the field. And listen, the giggling you hear, it's probably from Kurt and Shirley, playing tag and running through the tall grass. Sounds like heaven to me.
Thank you for those wonderful words of remembrance today. Now let us turn to the words of Scripture for consolation and hope this day. We begin with Psalm 23, and that is printed in your bulletin, so let us read that together. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil. My cup overflows. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Psalm 121. I lift my eyes to the hills. From where will my help come? My help comes from the Lord, who made heaven and earth. He will not let your foot be moved. He who keeps you will not slumber. He who keeps Israel will neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord is your keeper. The Lord is your shade at your right hand. The sun shall not strike you by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord will keep you from all evil. He will keep your life. The Lord will keep your going out and your coming in from this time on and forevermore. From Revelation chapter 22. Then the angel showed me the river of the water of life, bright as crystal, flowing from the throne of God and of the Lamb through the middle of the street of the city. On either side of the river is the tree of life with its 12 kinds of fruit, producing its fruit each month, and the leaves of the trees are for the healing of the nations. Nothing accursed will be found there anymore, but the throne of God and the Lamb will be in it, and his servants will worship him. They will see his face, and his name will be on their foreheads, and there will be no more night. They will need no light of lamp or sun, for the Lord God will be their light, and they will reign forever and ever. And he said to me, "These words are trustworthy and true. For the Lord, the God of the spirits of the prophets, has sent his angel to show his servants what must soon take place. See, I am coming. Blessed is the one who keeps the words of the prophecy of this book." And John, chapter 3, verse 16. "For God so loved that he gave his only Son, so that everyone who believes in him may not perish, but have eternal life." Grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. On behalf of Decorah Lutheran Church and the good men of the Helms Funeral Home, let me say how sorry we are for your loss. Between moving to Wellington Place a few years ago now and then the death of her husband in 2018, the pandemic that shut everything down, and then her move from the nursing, from assisted living over to the nursing home in the last few months, DeLoris went through a lot in these last years, didn't she? But these last years were really only a part of the life that she lived. And so, for as difficult as these days may be, I hope that you can take comfort in all of the years of her life, in all of the stories that you have shared. These difficult days now have come to an end for her, and she does rest in peace. So if there is anything else that we can do, please let us know. Again, we're very sorry for your loss. From what you've all shared with me, DeLoris was the poster child for a good mother. She cared deeply for her family, doing things like making clothes for her children, all six of them, as they grew up. She was the kind of mother who loved all sorts of music and passed that on to her children, making sure that they played musical instruments as they grew up. She was a mother who tended to the needs of her children and to whatever they got into. For instance, I've heard stories about the animals that they would bring home. But those animals always seem to find a welcome in the home. We've heard other great remembrances today, and we must remember that her care extended beyond just for her husband and her own children. But DeLoris loved grandchildren who will dearly miss her. She was always good about making everyone feel welcomed, from the step-grandchildren, to boyfriends and girlfriends, to in-laws, to community members. She had a way of caring and tending to others. Today we've heard from two of the great Psalms, the 23rd Psalm in which we recall that our Lord tends to us like a good shepherd. And then from Psalm 121, where we hear how God watches over us day and night. In her deep faith, I know that DeLoris learned from the Lord and acted out her faith as one who tended to her flock, as one who watched over her people. Now her time of watching and tending are at an end, but not our Lord's. God's tender mercy follows each and every one of us all the days of our lives. God's watchful eye neither slumbers nor sleeps. For every mother in this world that ever gave a lifetime of love to her family, they are molded in the image of the one who gives an eternity of love to his people. For God so loved the world, we are reminded today, that he gave his only Son, our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, so that we might know the everlasting life that comes through his name. DeLoris knew that life. And she knew to be thankful for that life. "You've got to be thankful," she would tell her kids. And then, in her aging days, her kids would tell her the same thing. Mom, you've got to be thankful. You have to be thankful for all of the blessings that God has given. And she was. She was thankful for what God had given her. She taught her family how to make the most out of what you have and how to share and care for others. She loved trying new things, learning about the world, keeping up with the news, and even into late life, she would pick up new hobbies along the way. When you came in, did you see the fantastic wood carving of the Lord's Prayer? I hope that you had a moment to look at that. But if you didn't, you'll be able to see it because it's staying here. The family is so graciously donating that to this church to put on display that intricate work that they put so much time into. We will gladly display that here. Yes, DeLoris' life was so full. But all of our days are numbered, as we know. And the life that we love so much does come to an end. I know that was a difficult change for DeLoris in her last days to no longer be the caregiver, no longer be the one who was tending to others. Then she needed the care. Then she needed the tending. She needed that shepherd to guide her. I'm told that she used to say that dying was like Jesus taking your hand and bringing you upstairs. What a beautiful image. What a motherly thing. I suppose each of you children had that experience when you were younger, that your mother would take your hand and bring you upstairs and put you to bed safe and sound. That is now true for DeLoris. Her Lord and Savior has taken her by the hand and led her to blessed rest and peace in that heavenly home waiting for her. And that is the hope that we all hold on to as well. The hope that for our own lives, one day the Lord who cares for us and watches over us, one day will take our hands and lead us up the stairs to our eternal rest as well. And so with that beautiful image in mind, it is good for us to sing together hymn number 773, Precious Lord, Take My Hand and Lead Me.
Thank you.
Together with the whole church in heaven and on earth, we confess our faith using the words of the Apostles' Creed that is printed on page 282. Let us confess our faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty God, in holy baptism, you have knit your chosen people together into one communion of saints in the body of Christ. Give to your whole church in heaven and on earth your light and your peace. God of mercy, hear our prayer. Grant that all who have been baptized into Christ's death and resurrection may die to sin and rise to share the new life in Christ. God of mercy, hear our prayer. Give courage and faith to all who mourn, and assure in certain hope in your loving care that, casting all their sorrows on you, they may have strength for the days ahead. God of mercy, hear our prayer. Grant to us who are still in our pilgrimage and who walk as yet by faith, that where this world groans in grief and pain, your Holy Spirit may lead us to bear witness to your light and life. God of mercy, hear our prayer. Help us, Lord, in the midst of things we cannot understand, to believe and to trust in the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, and the resurrection to life everlasting. God of mercy, hear our prayer. God of all grace, we give you thanks because by his death our Savior Jesus Christ destroyed the power of death, and by his resurrection he opened the kingdom of heaven to all believers. Make us certain that because he lives, we shall live also, and that neither death nor life, nor things present nor things to come, will be able to separate us from your love in Christ Jesus our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God now and forever. Amen. Gathered into one by the Holy Spirit, let us pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Let us commend DeLoris to the mercy of God, our Maker and our Redeemer. Please rise. Into your hands, O merciful Savior, we commend your servant, DeLoris Thornton. Acknowledge, we humbly beseech you, a sheep of your own fold, a lamb of your own flock, a sinner of your own redeeming. Receive her into the arms of your mercy, into the blessed rest of everlasting peace, and into the glorious company of the saints in light. Amen. We will sing together, How Great Thou Art, hymn number 856. Immediately following this service, the family will be going to Phelps Cemetery to lay DeLoris to rest, and you are welcome to come with, but you are also welcome to go directly downstairs to the meal that is prepared for us to be together and console one another. So at this time, let us pray for that meal. God, we give you thanks for the gift of the food that will feed us and the conversation that will inspire us. Send your Holy Spirit to grace our table and to grace our conversation, that we may be supported for the days ahead. This we pray in Jesus' holy name. Amen. Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, bless and preserve you now and into eternity. Amen.
Some glad morning when this life is over, I'll fly away to a home on God's celestial shore. I'll fly away, I'll fly away, oh glory, I'll fly away. When I die, hallelujah, by and by, I'll fly away. Just a few more weary days and then I'll fly away to a land where joy shall never end. I'll fly away, I'll fly away, oh glory, I'll fly away. When I die, hallelujah, by and by,